So I'm live in Durango right now. Well, you can't see me well, but I suppose I can do. Behind me is the dinosaur train. It just came in. By tomorrow I'll be on the train up to Soapton. So hopefully we're coming live on the train. Hopefully it has Wi-Fi on it so I'll be talking to you later. Next one's not till 5:10.
Okay.
So we got a while.
Yeah.
That's why they're shutting. I know 482 has been restored so many times. They've restored that engine so many times. It's hard to tell which, what it is again. If it's old, new, old, new, old, new. So hard. I do the Durango Soapton when I'm off.
Wow.
And then I do the Cumbres and Toltec when I'm other places. If you want to watch how I'm videotaping, you can. I got actually, I can get the train. I'm zoomed in. I'm zoomed in. He's coming this way. He's going back into the depot. dinosaur train coming in. First one. This is the first dinosaur train coming in. There's two of them out. This is the first one coming in. First dinosaur train coming in. Yeah. Miller Highway. That's up there. So is the next one powered by steam, or is it diesel powered?
Next one in will be about 5.
Next dinosaur train.
There's no next dinosaur.
There's 2, they said, in the depot, out.
That's it.
Oh, that's it? That's the second one that came around?
Come back again.
Okay. So which steamers are out?
They're all over to now. They'll be due, first one's due back about 5:10.
Okay.
5:10.
All right, but what engine numbers?
5:10, 6:45.
Okay, so what numbers are they?
Whatever they got running last night. We had everything break down last night. I have no idea what they sent out this morning.
Ooh, that's not good. Which engines broke down?
Everything.
Ooh.
I didn't get out here until 1 in the morning.
Wow.
The last locomotive got in here about 3 this
morning. Wow, that late?
Yep.
Damn. Like
2 miles.
is 463 in the Chumley yard, all steamed up. It's switching cars around for the next train tomorrow. And they're trying out some cars because they're restoring some of the cars that you see right here.
Yeah.
They're moving them around. Yeah, they're moving them around.
Okay.
To get them ready for to run again.
Okay.
Because they're going to have a freight special in August.
So it's backing up.
Yeah, he's switching around. Yeah, he's turning around. And the next train from Osier is coming, should be in soon. It's supposed to be here by 4, but he's running a little late. Unless he's coming in now, but I doubt it. He's coming in the other way. And he's going to stop at this platform here.
This guy is?
No, the other train that's okay. With the passenger coaches are coming.
Okay.
Still.
So he's trying to get pushed around and get other cars before
yeah.
This guy comes in.
Yep, that's what he's trying to do. He's saying move. We got.
Huh?
They're saying move. We don't want to get covered in soot. I was just on the drain on Silverton.
Was it?
Yesterday.
What train did you ride?
I was riding 473.
Oh, the third train.
Yeah.
I'm the night watchman. I prepped the engines in the morning.
Yep. I was doing the brakeman for 473.
Oh, you was?
I was in the back of the Rio Grande car with the brakeman. Dylan.
Dylan?
Yeah. The guy who did the third train yesterday.
I don't ever see. I never get out on the platform.
You should come out on the platform sometimes.
Usually I'm going home. But
you should come out and see what's going on.
Oh, I was in the car barn last year, so.
Yeah. I noticed the Nomad was in the car barn, too, getting repaired.
It's getting annualed.
Yeah, I thought so. Because the General Plumber's in the museum.
It pretty much stays there.
Yeah, they don't. I'm shocked that they put the Rio Grande car in the back instead of in front of the red San Juan. They should have put the San Juan in the back of the Rio Grande car.
That's just the way they've done that one since they got the...
Yeah, but that's not the way it usually goes. I know, because I've seen it on YouTube, how it's the Rio Grande, then the San Juan.
It's been like that for 2 years.
Wow, they need to change it.
I actually got the night sky. They...
Yeah, I know. I saw the night sky. It's red.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. It looks like the old original RGS Rio Grande Silver Vista. The one that burned.
Exact copy.
Yeah, that one, the original one that burned.
Yeah, it's exact copy of the other Silver Vista.
Yeah, of the Durango one, yeah.
Yeah.
How were they able to copy that one, I wonder?
I got the blueprints.
Oh, they still have the blueprints?
Oh, yeah.
I would have thought they would have gotten rid of them by now.
Oh, no.
Okay, good.
They have all the blueprints in the office.
I have the blueprints of the RGS-42. The original ones.
Oh, that's pretty good, that.
Yeah. That's the engine I'm going after. If Jeff Ellington would let me get to it, he was nothing but a twit.
That engine needs a lot of work.
I don't care. I would rather work on it. If it needs a lot of work, I can do it.
It needs a boiler.
Yeah, so I'm not worried about it. I can just put a boiler on.
That's a big expense, but it can be done.
Yeah. That engine needs to be fixed badly so we can get it running again.
Yeah.
That engine's been sitting in the museum way too long. That's what I say.
Yeah, it's just...
And we need a rotary up there. one of these guys to battle the snow.
No, they don't.
Yeah, I know, but when the Flander train gets stuck, they need one of these to back it up.
Well, they've got snow plows with snow blowers on them.
Yeah, but they don't usually work as well as the rotary does. No, keep going down that way. Yep. You may not want to stand there when the train departs.
We won't be here when the train departs.
All right.
Did you take it off?
It's that way. Yeah, keep going. You can't miss it. There we go, we're ready to go cross and stop traffic. Hold on, we got a train coming. It's a GE engine, that's what it is. I got plenty of pictures on my computer of this train coming back and forth.
488 is getting ready to go. Moving out slowly. Now I'm gonna go switch the tracks up ahead. Stop on 488 until the 483 get ahead. we're switching to do first. See, I took off the caboose so I can be able to take the train through. Charge it now. Here we are, folks. We're at Coombers Pass, where 483 is ending, right here. Now 488 is going to continue on.
steamers are on the way. I just heard one blow its whistle. Wow, it's real close. It's getting closer and closer by the minute. Wow. She sounds beautiful, whoever it is. Here it comes. Look right out there. All aboard. Perfect. Got it. It's 473.
Yes.
You sometimes when the 473 comes, that's perfect sign. Because they paint it in bumblebee color sometimes. It's 473 that's inbound. Yay! She works! You might want to stay back over there. Not too close. Hey, Mom. Mom, guess who's coming in right now? 473, the train's coming in now. If you want to come see it, come in. Yeah, she's coming in real fast. Yeah, my battery's going low on the camera, Mom. I need new... I'm going to have to buy some batteries for it. I didn't know I needed batteries. I put fresh ones in this morning. I've been taking photographs and stuff. Okay. All right. All right. Yeah. Bye. Better this time than yesterday being late.
Yeah, right.
You guys are in big trouble for that. Timbers? This train. the hot shot moon for any of them. Not worth it.
Kid years.
Yeah.
Moved to Georgia for a short 3 years, and then I moved to graduate high school from Maryland.
Here we go.
No kidding.
Oh, because I had a friend who graduated from POCO, and
I was going to POCO until they built my senior year. I transferred to Maryland.
Wow. Well, you would have missed him because Kim's younger than us, so he would have been before you. But yeah, Kim lived in graduated from. But our dearest friends in Orlando, born and raised in Orlando, he graduated from North Park High School. Born and raised
in Florida. Way south. 35th Street.
Yeah, okay.
Gary's not the end of there.
Oh, yes. When we first moved there, we did Gary's Duck Inn, loved it. And then 33rd Street now is the lockup. Everyone in town knows 33rd Street. That's its famed now. It's the county lockup, which is where you get locked up. It's a county, city, all the jails and everything are 33rd Street.
Well, I tell you, a few years ago when the kids were smaller.
Yep, we got backpackers. We have to take halfway and drop off.
I figured I'm going to drop off and find the old house. So I dropped off the interstate.
Did you?
Yep, we have to take the backpackers up halfway. And then we'll have to pick them up when we get back. Maybe, I don't know.
I was looking at it and focusing attention on
the house.
Huh?
It looks like coal.
It is. Yeah, it's real coal. Because this is coal-fired engines.
Yeah.
Coomers and Toltec is coal-fired.
About 3 blocks away where my elementary school was, they had 10-foot cyclone fences with barbed wire on top. And I used to walk this morning, no big deal.
That's why I didn't think you could find it, because that whole area is totally changed. Pulling everything down nearly there. And, like you say, 33rd Street, that's where they built the big lockup. It's a huge lockup.
Well, you know, by now it might. That was probably 15 years ago when I found it. So maybe it's gone now.
Yeah, we saw so many changes in Orlando in the 34 years we were there. My parents actually lived there. That's why we chose Orlando, because they were living there. We come down.
Yeah, it's going to leave at 8:42. Or, no, 8:45. Yeah, so they're just getting ready. Next one's boarding at 9.
Yeah.
Yeah. What car are you riding in? Yeah, is it, which color, is it a private car?
No.
Or is it one of the regular coaches?
One of the regular.
Yeah, so you might be up front or in back, one of the two. Yep. The one in New Mexico is called the Cumbres and Toltec. Uh-huh. Because that's the one I work for.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it is. This is 481 backing up. Which one are you taking?
The 830.
Yep, go ahead and go forward. We're going.